but I bumped into a man with whom I have a personal connection with but have never met, who traveled all the way from Australia to be here. So I'd like to introduce you to Chief Petty Officer Calum Blake.
John O'Day and Janet O'Day sent my grandfather a mock-up of an old army tin, and in the army tin was some information and brochures about the rooms, essentially, and the 100th anniversary and what they're going to display here today. So he received that quite a few years ago, and shortly before his death, just pretty much before he died, he was well aware that he was probably not going to make the 100 year anniversary. So one time when I was down visiting at some random time, he pulled this box out and explained to me, you know, what this was about, talked a little bit about Newfoundland and the people over here and all the rest of it. And he said, quite told me that being the only, at that time, the only serving member in military in our family, he asked slash told if I could come here on his behalf and represent. So that's why I've come halfway across the world to do this, essentially, yeah.
He died about a year and a half ago, and just on his deathbed, he asked me if I could do the honour and represent him here for this anniversary.
The years before he died, he made lots of comments about how he just, he loved them, enjoyed them, felt connected with them. They, you know, obviously they were Newfoundlanders and he was an English officer, and there was not any, you know, they trusted him. So they got to know him and he got to know them very well. Fish Lake, Cam Eaton, some other, Peter McNeely. So there's a lot of names in the book which he met, and so he fought with them. You know, after 46 years later, after going back to England, Scotland, and then eventually moving across to Australia, down to Albany where he lived, he managed to get in touch with Cam Eaton and discover that Cam was coming to Australia essentially and wanted to catch up. I think some of Cam's family were a bit dubious, you know, you haven't seen this bloke in 46 years, surely you wouldn't connect and all the rest of it. But I remember, in his diaries, they said, no, not a problem at all. It's like it was just yesterday. And from reading those, it was, you know, they saw each other, met, and then just, yeah, had a really good, continued the friendship and the bond that they had got from the war, essentially. And so he came to Newfoundland not long after that, and again, and again and again. So I think four or five times he ended up coming across.
In his diary, I remember him saying, from the first time, what have I done to deserve this? To meet these Newfoundlanders and because of a ragtag bunch. But after his time and all through the service, he couldn't praise them high enough. Just the bravery and the camaraderie that they had with each other, and the way that they welcomed him into their regiment was absolutely outstanding.